Hi there, and welcome to this special masterclass on how to conquer your cravings and stop emotional eating. My name is Karen Donaldson. I'm a registered dietitian and an emotional eating and mindset expert, which means I get to help women lose the weight and keep it off without dieting and deprivation. And I'm so glad you're here because I know how much this is going to help you. So let's get started. This masterclass is for women who feel powerless when it comes to their cravings and emotional eating, eat when they're stressed, anxious, bored, or overwhelmed, or overeat to numb out, tranquilize their emotions, or comfort themselves. It's also for women who know that diets and deprivation don't work, who are tired of stressing and obsessing about what to eat and what not to eat, and are afraid that nothing will ever work. And it's for women who are worried about their health because of their weight issues, have guilt and shame about their food choices and about their bodies, and are totally frustrated with the never-ending cycle of losing the weight and gaining it back. Have you ever heard yourself say, "I know what I'm supposed to do, so why can't I do it?" I know that I asked myself that same question for years. It was ridiculous, really, especially since I'm a dietitian, but I hear this from my new clients all the time, which is why I really like this quote from Einstein. The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. I have definitely been there, done that, and I'm guessing you have too. So, are you ready for some different results? Some better results? Some lasting results? If you are ready to conquer your cravings, stop emotional eating, lose the weight, and keep it off, then this masterclass is definitely for you. In the next 45 minutes, I'm going to share with you how to conquer your cravings before they even get started, when you're stressed out, anxious, overwhelmed, before you're headed for the pantry or the fridge, so you can be done with that battle and have peace around food no matter where you are or what you're doing. I'll also explain why stressing and obsessing about what you're eating and what you're not eating is one of the very worst things you can do when you're trying to lose weight, and I'll share a simple strategy to help you stop eating under the influence of guilt and shame. I'm also going to reveal the real reasons, we're talking about some cool brain chemistry stuff here, that we self-medicate with carbs, and how to stop emotional eating even if you've been using food to stuff your feelings or fill a void for as long as you can remember. And I'm going to teach you what you need to know to reprogram your subconscious mind, because that's what controls about 90% of what you eat, how much you eat, and why you eat it, so you can finally get off the dieting roller coaster once and for all. And last, but certainly not least, I'm going to give you the exact strategies that my clients use that you can use too, to let go of the self-sabotaging habits and patterns that are keeping you stuck, being your own worst enemy, so you can finally release the weight and keep it off permanently. Wouldn't that be great? I've been helping women overcome their food and body issues for over 20 years, and here's what so many women say to me, and maybe this sounds like you too. You just want to lose weight and keep it off. And you want it to be easy, uncomplicated, and sustainable, like something you could truly do for the rest of your life. But instead, this is what's going on. Your emotions are running the show. You know you're using food as your drug of choice to make you feel better, but you're powerless to stop doing it. You really struggle with overeating, whether it's big portions or stress eating or mindless bored eating, or maybe it's more serious emotional eating. And even though you know better logically, it doesn't seem to matter. And it feels like you're in a constant battle with food and also with your body. And it's stressful, exhausting, and overwhelming. And quite frankly, you're probably beginning to wonder if anything will ever work. If you're like me and many of my clients, before we understood what was really going on, maybe you're thinking you just need to try harder. I literally hear this every day, even though my clients are trying really hard and have been working at this for years, and that might be true for you as well, there's still that war going on in your head that says, maybe you just need to spend more time searching the web and staying up way too late looking for that one diet, cleanse, or food challenge that will magically make your weight disappear. Or maybe you just need to cut your carbs even lower or be more strict with your macros or buy some fancy exercise equipment or get an expensive personal trainer, maybe fork over more cash for some different pills or potions, or maybe you just need to give up eating altogether. Yep, maybe then you'd see some results. If this is you, I've got good news. None of these things are the real problem. The real problem is what you are thinking and what you are feeling, which means the real problem is what's going on in your head and in your heart. You could have the best plan in the world and try harder to do all that stuff, but you will never be successful without the right mindset and the right heart set. So what exactly is mindset and heart set? Let's start with mindset. Basically, mindset is your beliefs about what is possible for you. But here's the kicker. These beliefs often come from other people, which means they're not even your beliefs to begin with. They come from your parents, teachers, religious leaders, family, friends, or stuff you read or watch or listen to, even social media. And these beliefs also come from your childhood experiences, all the things that happened to you while you were growing up, the good stuff and the not so good stuff. And here's what happens. Your subconscious mind uses all of your experiences and emotions and feelings to form your beliefs. And it's these beliefs that become your habits and patterns, even when it comes to your weight. These beliefs are then stored, similar to how the hard drive on your computer stores data. And when it's time to make a decision about what to eat or how much to eat, your mind retrieves the data and makes sure you respond exactly the way you were programmed, even if it means your actions and behaviors go against what you're consciously thinking. For example, you can say, "I want to lose weight." But if your subconscious is saying, "Oh, I'm tired of depriving myself and thinking about food all the time," or "I don't want to torture myself at the gym," or "I'm tired of losing weight and then gaining it all back, and it's just too freaking hard, and besides, nothing that I do works anyway." Or you might be thinking thoughts like, "I can't lose weight," because you have beliefs like, "Obesity runs in my family. I can't control my cravings. I'll never be able to stop my emotional eating. I wouldn't even know who I was without this weight," or "It's not safe for me to be thin," or "I don't know how to stop sabotaging myself anyway." So what most people struggling to lose weight don't realize is that your subconscious mind holds on to these limiting beliefs and self-doubts and sabotaging patterns and keeps you stuck, frustrated, and hopeless. In other words, it's your subconscious beliefs that determine whether or not you are successful with losing the weight and keeping it off, because your subconscious beliefs are what's known as your weight loss blockers. The bottom line is that if you want to conquer your cravings and stop emotional eating so you can release the weight and keep it off, you need to reprogram your subconscious mind and get a new mindset that works for you instead of against you. It looks like this. New beliefs equals a new mindset, which means new and better results. And that's what we're going for. And there's something else that's just as important as your mindset, and that's what I call your heart set. So what is heart set? Well, your heart set is your emotions. It's how you feel. And how you feel plays a huge role when it comes to your food and body issues, because the bottom line is your emotions are triggering your cravings and your emotional eating. You see, when you are holding on to emotions such as anger, guilt, shame, sadness, anxiety, or really any powerful emotion, or when you have deeper conflicts going on, such as feelings of not being good enough, low self-esteem, or hopelessness, your heart is not happy. And when your heart is not happy, you find yourself using food to comfort and nurture yourself, reward yourself, tranquilize what you don't want to feel, unwind from the stress of the day, calm down your anxiety, or just give you something to do. So let me ask you this. Have you ever found yourself in the kitchen, standing in front of the fridge or the pantry because you just need something? I know I used to do this all the time, and it had nothing to do with physical hunger. I could have just finished dinner 5 minutes ago and still be stocking the fridge. And that, my friend, that's emotional hunger. And with emotional hunger, you might also find yourself using food to do things like gain a sense of control if you're feeling out of control, or to punish yourself with some sort of destructive behavior. And many women use food to protect themselves or to feel safe or to fill a void or to feel loved. It's a bit frightening, but experts say as much as 75% of our overeating may be in response to our emotions rather than to our physical hunger. I know this. I was a big part of these statistics for years, and I'm so glad I'm not there anymore. But I can still remember all those times I was sitting on the couch, binging on Netflix, or mindlessly scrolling on my phone with my hand in a bag of tortilla chips, not even tasting them anymore. That was totally cravings and emotional eating. Because here's the deal. You can use food to feel better, and it does work in the moment. But the truth is that the feelings that triggered the emotional eating in the first place are still there when the bag of chips is gone or when the empty carton of ice cream is at the bottom of the garbage can. And it's these underlying feelings and emotions that are sabotaging you when it comes to releasing the weight and keeping it off. Until you resolve the underlying emotions and conflicts, nothing changes. If you really want to release the weight and keep it off, you need to heal your heart. Because healed emotions means a happy heart, which means great and happy results. So here's my promise to you. Today I'm going to give you the exact 5 steps you need to master your mindset and heal your heart so you can conquer your cravings, stop your emotional eating, and have lasting weight loss. You don't have to buy anything to get this information, but I am going to have a gift for you when we're done with this masterclass. So be sure to stay tuned until the end so you can receive it. And now, who am I and why should you listen to me? Well, my name is Karen Donaldson. I'm a registered clinical dietitian in private practice for about 15 years, and I'm also a consulting dietitian for medical offices in my community. I have a bachelor's degree in microbiology and dietetics, and also a master's degree in microbiology and biochemistry. And this means that I really understand the science of how food affects our bodies and our minds. Clinically, I'm also an expert in health conditions like high cholesterol, insulin resistance, diabetes, overweight, and obesity. And while I do love being a registered dietitian, what I get the very most excited about when it comes to helping my clients is that I am an emotional eating expert. I am an Emotional Freedom Techniques, EFT, certified practitioner, and an EFT certified weight loss coach. And I have advanced training in energy healing modalities like the emotion code and the body code, which I use to help my clients clear trapped emotions and heart walls and correct energy imbalances in the body to help calm their cravings and stop emotional eating. I also use several other mind-body energy techniques that help my clients balance the emotion centers in their body so they can release the weight. And I am a weight loss mindset expert, which means I get to help my clients rewire their brains to release the weight, which is truly one of the most fascinating pieces of the puzzle when it comes to permanent weight loss. I'm also an author and a speaker, and I love presenting at conferences, and I'm the recipient of some pretty cool awards like the Healthcare Hero Award and the Business Person of the Year for Service Award. Most importantly, I have mentored thousands of women to success with losing weight and keeping it off with the added bonus of getting to see so many other areas of their lives improve as a result. Their relationships with themselves and with others, their money, their finances, careers, and even more. So my job is truly one of the best on the planet. Oh, and I also love being outdoors, gardening or hiking or biking with my family and friends, or just hanging out with my puppies. And this is Sam and Bob. I'm also a woman who gets it because I was struggling too. I would be really good in public, but secretly, like when nobody was around, I would binge on popcorn, waffles, and chocolate after everybody went to bed. Or maybe I would have corn chips for a little snack right after breakfast when there was no possible way I could be hungry. Or in some of my finer moments, I would stop and buy raw cookie dough on the way home from work, eat the entire carton as I was driving, and then throw it in the outside garbage can so nobody would see it. Can you relate? I know whenever I share these stories with the women I work with, they're nodding their heads in agreement. They're like, yes, yes, oh my gosh, I do that too. I also had a lot of stress and anxiety about my food and my exercise. I had to make sure food was around wherever I went, in the car, at my office, on a road trip, even if it was just a short 45-minute drive to the next town. And it was weird. I would get nervous if I had to share a dessert, like, geez, I hope there's going to be enough for me. And I had to know exactly what I was eating and when I was going to eat it. So going out to restaurants became a bit of a challenge. And when it came to family events, even just thinking about food would make me anxious. Even trying to plan meals and grocery shop was enough to make me buy a donut at the store, which of course I had to be sneaky about because I didn't want anybody to see what I was buying. And I was also stressed about my exercise. What if being a personal trainer and teaching fitness classes wasn't enough? What if I couldn't work out? I was also very obsessed about my weight. And yes, I weighed myself every day, sometimes several times a day, but obsessively weighing didn't help me lose weight either because my weight just kept on creeping up. And I'm sure you have probably said this to yourself before. I would promise each morning to be good and then it would start all over again. And this was super stressful because I felt like a fraud and a hypocrite. I mean, what the heck? This is my job. I should know how to do this, right? I'm a nutrition expert. I'm a dietitian. So here is the honest truth that I really didn't want to admit. I was struggling with cravings and emotional eating just like my clients were. How on earth was I going to help people if I couldn't help myself? But I found out it wasn't just me and it wasn't just my clients. Nearly everyone I knew was struggling. Coaches and trainers were struggling despite the fact that their clients had paid them tons of money to come up with elaborate nutrition and exercise plans. And even the doctors weren't having luck. Their patients had done programs, pills and potions, and even had weight loss surgery, but they still couldn't keep the weight off. So what the heck was going on? There had to be more to the story. Because being a dietitian wasn't enough. Knowing clinical stuff about weight loss wasn't enough. Knowing about diets wasn't enough. Because even with all of this knowledge, when I was stressed, I made popcorn. And when I was bored, I craved cookies. When I was lonely, chocolate was my friend. And then it hit me. One of those infamous aha moments when the light bulb comes on and shines very brightly. It's not about the food. It really isn't. Yes, of course nutrition is important, but instead of obsessing about what we are eating and how much we are eating, the answer lies in resolving why we are overeating. What it really comes down to is what we are thinking and what we are feeling. From that moment on, I started learning everything I could about how to shift my thinking, let go of my negative emotions, and heal my heart. And it worked. The results were amazing, and it's still working. I conquered my cravings, which was really nice because I was finally able to stop reaching for sugar and carbs every time I was stressed or anxious. And I also stopped my emotional eating, which means now I can actually eat what I call normal popcorn instead of emotional popcorn. In fact, I can actually eat a little out of the bowl and throw the rest in the garbage if I'm not hungry, which is so cool. And of course, that means I lost weight because my emotional hunger was gone. And I'm still keeping it off many, many years later. I even remember taking some clothes to the donation center and not even worrying about keeping the larger sizes because I know for sure I'm in the right heart set and the right mindset to keep it off. And while I'm really happy for myself, the best part is that the women I work with started getting these same great results, and they still are. And this changed everything. It completely revolutionized the way that I work with my clients, and for that, I am truly grateful. I'm going to be sharing some incredible stories of the women who have conquered their cravings, stopped their emotional eating, lost the weight and kept it off, and learned to like themselves and love themselves in the process. And I'm going to tell you exactly what they did to make this happen. Are you ready? I am, because I know you are going to love this. So here we go. These are the 5 steps you need to master your mindset and heal your heart, so you can conquer your cravings, stop your emotional eating, and permanently release the weight. Step number one, you have got to calm the chaos and stop the stress response that's going on inside your mind and inside your body. If you're in a constant state of stress or fight or flight mode, or you're always feeling overwhelmed, you simply won't be able to release the weight. And here's why. Stress triggers the emotion center of your brain, which is called the amygdala. Your amygdala then sends a danger signal to the command center of your brain, your hypothalamus. In response to this danger, your body starts making stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline. Oh, and your liver kicks in to help too. It releases extra sugar into your blood to help you fight the battle. If only there was really a battle or a real bear in the woods. This is a great response when you're truly in danger of being harmed, but it totally backfires for your body when the stress response is going on in your mind or in your heart. Because when you're in the stress response mode, your body has basically created the perfect storm to store fat right in your belly. Your metabolism is slower because energy is being diverted away from digestion. You start using food to cope. Your cravings and emotional eating become out of control, and you feel depleted, exhausted, and maybe even depressed. So basically, your body goes into survival mode and stores fat to keep you safe. And I know people are always talking about how important it is to manage your stress, and we're always like, yeah, whatever. But I'm telling you for sure, this is real. I've had so many clients doing everything right with their diet, which we're going to talk about next, and killing themselves at the gym, which also doesn't work. But their response to the stress is ruining all their results. So this is a really, really important step. To stop the stress response, you need to calm the chaos with mind-body tools like EFT tapping, which I'm going to talk about more, and meditations and energy balancing routines to get you more centered. A technique that I really love and that I love teaching my clients is emotional freedom techniques, EFT, which is also known as tapping, because it works on so many of the problem areas for weight loss, like stress, anxiety, and cravings. And it's backed by science. There are clinical research studies that show that the type of EFT tapping I use in my programs decreases stress hormones like cortisol, which is a fat-storing hormone, and calms down the symptoms of anxiety, which I often call chaos brain, which is really common for people struggling with food issues. And the research studies also showed that the type of EFT tapping that I use deactivated the part of the brain that was stimulated when test subjects were shown images of foods that were high in fat, salt, and sugar. And even more amazing, the technique that I teach actually rewired the pathways in the brain that are involved in addiction and food cravings and ended up diminishing the cravings. And if that's not exciting enough, the people who use this type of EFT as part of their weight loss plan continue to release weight after they completed the program. And this was a group that I was a facilitator for, so this is really quite exciting. And Nissa is a perfect example of how this works. She was stressed to the max, working two jobs, taking care of family, chronically in fight or flight mode, and totally depleted. And she was using popcorn and peanut butter to cope, which was keeping her completely stuck and not able to release any more weight. Using the techniques that I teach, she was able to calm down the chaos in her brain and calm her stress response, which totally got rid of her cravings. So now she doesn't have to use popcorn or peanut butter as her drug of choice anymore. And she released the weight and has kept it off. This is so amazing. I just love sharing stories like this because it demonstrates just how serious the effect of stress is when it comes to weight loss and why we really need to respect that and use really effective mind-body tools to lessen that effect. Okay, on to step number two, ditch the diet and deprivation. Yes, I know this sounds a bit crazy from a registered dietitian, but I have been helping women for decades now, and I can tell you with absolute certainty that diets don't work. And here are some very important reasons why. When you're on a diet, you are basically living in what I call negative energy mode, which is the emotions below the blue line, which means you're likely depriving yourself and restricting what you eat, which doesn't exactly put you in a good mood. And so you might be angry or have anxiety about it. And then when the diet doesn't work, or if you just can't do it anymore, you feel like a failure, or maybe you think you're just lazy. And then of course there's the guilt and the shame. And even if you're not familiar yet with how your emotions affect your success, which I'm gonna share in just a minute, I'm sure you can see that this is a recipe for disaster and for not getting the results that you desire. And I'm going to show you why it's absolutely crucial that we stay above the blue line in positive energy, especially when it comes to weight loss, so you can be inspired from a place of joy and actually get good results. So imagine you're eating under what I call the influence of guilt and shame, which is basically eating under the influence of all of those negative dieting emotions like guilt and shame that we just talked about. When you do this, you're sending signals to your body to create stress hormones like adrenaline and cortisol, and you basically start up that fight or flight response I was talking about in step one, and bam, before you know it, you end up storing fat, usually right in the belly, which is why you just have to ditch the dieting and the deprivation and give yourself permission to eat mindfully and joyfully so that your body can use the food that you ingest for good health. Because when you eat like this, you are in relaxed mode and you're making feel-good chemicals like dopamine and serotonin and oxytocin, and you're happy and your metabolism is happy, and your body uses the food as nourishment instead of storing it as fat. And I know this can be tricky, especially at first, because there is so much going on in our heads and in our hearts when it comes to eating, which is why I am sharing another very crucial step, which is step number three, heal your heart. As I mentioned earlier, what we're feeling very much affects our food choices. So it's absolutely vital that you become aware of what you're really craving and put your energy into healing your heart instead of being focused on what you should or shouldn't be eating. Because, as I'm sure you know, there is a huge difference between physical hunger and emotional hunger. When you eat to satisfy physical hunger, you're simply giving your body the food it needs to do its jobs. But emotional hunger is not about the food. Emotional hunger is about what you are feeling, and emotional hunger is about what is going on in your heart. And this is where it can get really confusing for your heart and for your head, because as it turns out, comfort foods have a very powerful effect on our minds and our bodies. And they do this by increasing the levels of feel-good neurotransmitters in your brain. Like, this is legit science. When you eat those comfort foods, especially those high in carbs, they indirectly raise the levels of serotonin in your brain, which makes you feel calm and relaxed. And if you're a woman struggling with any sort of food addiction, these foods can also increase your dopamine levels, which makes you feel really happy, but then you just end up wanting more and more and more. And before you know it, the box of chocolate or the bag of chips is gone. And the effects of these comfort foods, the effects they have on your brain, are really quite dramatic. They are basically hijacking your brain chemistry. They do make you feel better in the moment, but the results are disastrous for your weight and for your health. Now, we can try to overcome this with willpower, but the negative emotions that we're feeling and the heaviness of the deeper conflicts are really hard to fight, which means the desire to feel better almost always wins over logic. So even though we know better, of course we know better, but when your heart is not happy, it's like the carbs are knocking on your door and all logic goes out the window. And this is where I really, really love helping my clients, because I'm actually helping them get to the heart of the matter instead of just asking them to have more willpower, or instead of writing up yet another diet plan that we both know deep down is not going to work. And so for step three, to heal your heart, you begin by being honest about how you truly feel. And for many women, and this may be true for you, this actually means giving yourself permission to feel and to express your emotions instead of stuffing them down with food or pretending like they don't matter. The next step is to use advanced energy techniques like EFT tapping and some other modalities that I'm going to share with you in just a moment to help you release any negative emotions you're holding onto, and also to resolve the deeper issues that are at the core of your emotional eating. A couple of my favorite energy healing modalities are the emotion code and the body code. I use the emotion code to help my clients release trapped emotions that are keeping them stuck so they don't have to self-medicate with carbs to feel better. And I use the body code to help them release underlying energy imbalances so their bodies can begin to heal so they can actually release the weight. These specialized energy techniques also help my clients release what are called heart walls and body walls. Walls they put up to keep themselves safe from being hurt emotionally. And what's really cool about this type of energy work is that releasing these heart walls can help with weight loss, but it also helps with relationships. So I love telling the story of one of my clients who was able to release a huge heart wall. And in that same week, she dropped 5 pounds and she met the man of her dreams, which was totally awesome. I also love using EFT for the deeper issues that affect our weight, the weight loss blockers that not many people know about. But the other type of stress that is very triggering for weight is stress from our childhood experiences. This type of stress is called ACEs, which stands for adverse childhood experiences. And ACEs include things like not having your emotional or physical needs met as a child, any type of abuse, physical, sexual, or emotional, drugs, alcohol, or violence in the home, and other types of family dysfunction. And we know from very extensive research that ACEs increase stress hormones, and they also affect the way that your brain develops. And unfortunately, this means that having a history of adverse childhood experiences affects your physical, mental, and emotional health as an adult, including increasing your risk of being overweight or obese. So I think what's really important to note here is that our relationship with food is very complex, and there is so much more to the story than most people realize. I think we've always known that cravings and emotional eating were a problem, but it's only been in the last few years that the science has shown us just how significant our emotions are and our childhood experiences when it comes to our weight and our health. And what we're learning is that going on a diet is not going to fix this. So what happens if you don't heal your heart? Well, it's likely that your feelings will continue to control your eating, and you will keep stuffing your emotions and numbing your feelings. And you'll probably never release the physical weight because you're still carrying around the weight of the emotional baggage. So what happens if you do heal your heart? Well, it's great news, really. You are in control of your eating. Your cravings and emotional eating diminish. You finally stop sabotaging yourself. You're free of your emotional baggage, and you get to release the weight once and for all. And that's what happened with Melinda. Melinda has a history of lots of childhood trauma, which led her to eat to comfort herself, soothe, tranquilize, and numb herself. She had a ton of guilt and shame around food and around her body. She didn't like herself, she didn't love herself, and she felt very hopeless. This was actually affecting her entire life, her eating, her intimate relationships, even her finances. All of this was affected. And originally, she was referred to me by her doctor for diabetes, but I knew right away there was more to the story. So we got busy working on her heart set. I helped her release her negative emotions and resolve some pretty significant ACEs so that her heart could heal, so she could stop using food to feel better. And now I am so happy to say that each morning she wakes up and says, "I love you," to herself in the mirror. And yes, she did lose weight, and she is keeping it off, and she did improve her diabetes, which she said that was almost like a bonus because of how good she feels, anyway, thanks to all the healing work that she did. And something else Melinda did was step number 4, she rewired her brain. And this is an absolutely crucial step because your brain plays a very powerful role, one that you might not even be aware of when it comes to your weight. And here's how that works. Your conscious mind is your thinking mind and analytical mind, but it's actually your subconscious mind that dictates what you do, because your subconscious mind contains your belief systems that come from your feelings and emotions. And it's your subconscious mind that controls about 90% of your behaviors and your actions. In fact, the subconscious is about a million times more powerful than the conscious mind. And this means that your subconscious beliefs are running the show behind the scenes when it comes to weight loss. In other words, your subconscious beliefs are your weight loss blockers. Now, to be honest, that kind of freaked me out when I first learned that. I was like, what? My subconscious mind is in charge of my weight? What the heck am I supposed to do with that? Well, as it turns out, there is good news when it comes to reprogramming your subconscious. In fact, did you know? Research on neuroscience has shown you can create new pathways in your brain in 30 days or less. Well, that's actually pretty cool when you think about it, because what that means is that you really can rewire your brain to conquer your cravings, stop your emotional eating, and release the weight. And here's how you do it. First, you identify the old beliefs that are keeping you stuck. Next, you get clear on the thoughts and the beliefs that will help you achieve what you desire instead of what you don't desire. And then you use repetition and advanced mindset techniques like visualization, weight loss affirmations, and EFT tapping to turn your new thoughts into strong beliefs. And I know this isn't the usual step that women think of when they're trying to lose weight, and you may be tempted to skip this step, but if you don't reprogram your mindset, you will continue to make choices based on your old and very limiting beliefs, which means your mindset will continue to sabotage you and keep you stuck. And the bottom line is, you won't be successful at losing weight, and you won't be successful at keeping it off. But when you do rewire your brain to release the weight, the new beliefs in your subconscious mind start running the show. Your weight loss blockers are gone. Your mind starts working for you instead of against you. You become confident, you trust your body, you release the weight with ease, and you're able to keep it off for good. So take May for example. She had resigned herself to being older, heavier, and sicker. She had dieted nearly her whole life since the age of 16, and she told me quite frankly she just did not have the courage to try another diet. Thank goodness, right? She knew she needed something different, and using the tools and techniques she learned in my program, she completely shifted her mindset by rewiring her brain. And now she believes in herself. She has confidence in her body, her cravings and emotional eating are gone, and she naturally eats foods that work for her body, which allowed her to release over 65 pounds, and she's keeping it off. I love this because she still sends me emails letting me know how great she's doing, which is so amazing. So can you see why you definitely do not want to skip this step? And now, last but certainly not least, it's time for step number 5. And this is one of my favorite steps because for most of the women I know, it truly is time for them and for you to love yourself lighter. Because no matter how hard you try, if you don't shift your mindset and heal your heart, you will continue to struggle with cravings and emotional eating, and you won't be able to lose the weight. So it's absolutely imperative that you become that woman who loves herself on the inside so you can get the results that you want on the outside. Because the woman who loves herself lighter knows exactly how to take care of herself and her emotions in ways that are helpful and healing for her body. And she easily and joyfully is able to choose foods that serve her body for its highest and best good. She believes in herself and trusts her body, and she lives in a body that she loves. She also gets the guidance and support she needs, which means she works with the best mentor she can find, and she doesn't waste time and money staying stuck in the wrong mindset, letting her emotions dictate her food choices, trying to figure this out all by herself. And ladies, this is so important. I remember how I used to try to do everything on my own, figure out my weight, my business, my relationships, whatever, and all it really got me was years and years of frustration. But I finally got smart and I started using mentors, and I can't even believe what a difference this has made in my life. It truly was life-changing because the reality is that we all need help sometimes. And also, it's so much faster and easier and ends up being less expensive, actually, because I got to quit wasting time and money. And it's also much more effective because I finally got the results I was looking for. So I really want to encourage you to do the same. Allow yourself to receive the guidance and the support to get the results that you truly do deserve. So I recommend loving yourself lighter by choosing a mentor with a step-by-step system who has years of experience and education with proven results that are backed by science, and a mentor who truly cares for you and will be there for you every step of the way. Because if you don't become that confident woman who loves herself, you will stay stuck. And your old beliefs will run the show. You'll be hanging on to your emotional baggage as well as your excess physical weight and not getting the results that you really deserve. But when you do love yourself lighter, you know how to conquer your cravings and stop emotional eating so that you can finally release the weight once and for all. Take Deb, for example. She really used to struggle with making herself a priority. She was always doing for others first. Her self-esteem was really low, and she was using food to stuff her feelings. But by working with me in my program, she learned how to take care of herself while still caring for others. I also taught her mindful ways to speak up for herself and manage her stress so she could stop using food to cope. And she learned to like herself and to love herself. Can you see that great smile? Oh, and now she actually loves to move her body. Some people call this exercise, but we call it joyful movement. And because of all the mindset and the heart set work that we did together, she was also able to release excess physical weight, which was truly great because what that meant was that her happiness on the inside helped her create her happiness on the outside. And this is really what it's all about. So today, I promised I would share my exact 5 steps to conquer your cravings and stop your emotional eating so you can have lasting weight loss without diets and deprivation. And here's what you got to do. Step number 1, calm the chaos and stop the stress in your mind and in your body. Step 2, ditch the diets and deprivation. Step 3, release the negative emotions so your heart can be happy. Step 4, rewire your brain to release the weight. And step 5, invest in yourself to love yourself lighter. So what is the fastest, most effective, and most compassionate way for you to master your mindset and heal your heart so you can release the weight and keep it off? Well, first of all, learn from my experience. I've spent over 20 years and hundreds of thousands of dollars learning these steps. So in other words, don't spend years trying to figure this out on your own like I did. Let me do that work for you. I have helped thousands of women, and I would love to help you too. And now it's time to make a choice. Which path do you want to take? Now that you know that mastering your mindset and healing your heart are the steps you need to take, what do you want to do? Do you want to just keep struggling, trying to do it on your own, dieting or depriving yourself, doubting yourself, hoping that your cravings and emotional eating will just go away and wishing you could have lasting weight loss? Or do you want to be that woman who could release the weight and keep it off? Because, and I say this with the utmost kindness and respect, because I know how challenging this is, the truth is that if you could have done this on your own, you would have already done it. But I'm sure you figured out, likely the hard way, that fixing this just doesn't happen on its own. But the good news is that you don't have to do this alone. With the right tools and guidance and support, you can do this. And here's how I can help. I've set aside some time over the next few days to personally talk with you about what's going on in your mind and your heart that is stopping you from releasing the weight and keeping it off. Yep, I am inviting you to schedule your own 45-minute private one-on-one consultation with me, and the cost is absolutely free. This is my special gift to you. During our consultation, I will answer your questions and work with you to create a step-by-step plan for overcoming your cravings and your emotional eating so you can release the weight and keep it off too. And while I'm really excited to be giving you this gift, I want to let you know up front that this is not for everyone. This is not for you if you don't believe that your beliefs and your mindset matter, or if you're not ready to heal your heart and resolve the core issues around your emotional eating. And this is also not for you if you're just looking for another magic diet, or if you're really not ready to invest in yourself and in your health. However, this is for you if you are open to new ideas and new perspectives and new strategies, and you are ready and willing to let go of the emotions and the unresolved conflicts that have been sabotaging you. It's also for you if you're excited about having a step-by-step system that helps you rewire your brain to release the weight. And if you are a woman who is done with waiting and you're ready to take action now. So if this is you, let's get your consultation booked right now. Here's how it works. Click on the link on this page or go to excelweightloss.com/apply. Schedule a time on my calendar and fill out a brief assessment. And then after that, all you have to do is show up for your free consultation with me. Easy peasy. Now, you might be asking yourself, why is she doing this? Well, I do this because I absolutely love helping women conquer their cravings and stop their emotional eating so they can lose the weight and keep it off, of course, but it's so much more than that. When my clients heal their hearts and master their mindset, the possibilities are truly endless. The women I work with experience amazing transformations in every area of their lives, and I am truly blessed to be a part of that. I also know that you might want my help with this, and we can talk about that during our consultation as well. If we decide we're a good fit to work together, awesome. And if not, that's okay too. But I do want to let you know that spaces are limited. This is because I do these sessions myself. You won't be talking to my assistant or a salesperson or anything like that. It will just be you and me one-on-one, helping you discover the right path for you. And I'm really excited to meet you. So go ahead and click on the link or go to excelweightloss.com/apply and hop on my calendar right now. You are ready and you are worth it. And by the way, good job on showing up for yourself today. You deserve it. Thanks again, and I'll see you soon.